You know, like these kids are committing suicide. Parents don't know what these kids are doing, what they have in their bedroom. They don't try to keep an eye on their kids. And if they did, it will make a big, big difference in the family life. Just standing here thinking about the different situations with our children and the drug epidemic that's out here, it's just so sad because I was coming from a grocery store just the other day, and this gentleman just walked up to me as we were getting into our vehicles, and he just broke down and was crying with his packages. And I just said, "You all right, sir?" And he said, "No." He said, "I just lost my 17-year-old just before the holidays. He OD'd on drugs." And I kind of felt so bad for him. He said that was his only son. And he was saying that he just wanted to go out here and just hurt all of them that were selling the drugs out there on the streets. And I just asked him, did he want to pray about it? And he said, no. He just wanted to, he was so angry about it. And I told him to stop and think about it. It's just so, he wasn't the only one that had lost his child to drugs. And the bad, and the sad part about it is, it's so plentiful out here to our young kids. And the parents are not paying any attention to see what's going on with them.
Young man, I understand that you got arrested for selling drugs. Is that true?
Yes.
And what happened?
I was on the street selling drugs. I saw two little girls, and they bought them from me.
You sold to two little young girls?
Yes.
And what happened? Did they buy the drugs?
Yes.
Why are you selling drugs? You need the money?
Yes.
What you gonna buy with drug money, you know?
No.
What would you like to buy with drug money?
More drugs.
More drugs. So what happened after that? On your way counting your money, I saw you.
I got arrested.
You got arrested by who?
The cop.
The cop?
Mm-hmm.
I saw that cop, Officer Malik. He arrested you. So what do you plan on doing with the rest of your future? Are you going to continue in the path that you're leading to?
No.
Well, how come you're not in jail? You believe in God?
Yes.
You think he had anything to do with you being back on the street so soon?
Yes.
Did you thank God?
Yes.
And you finished with the drug dealing, right?
Yes.
Okay, young man. Have a good life. You got a long way ahead of you. You can get it right. Thank you.
It's these boys need a man in their life. You know, that would make a big difference, too, to really try to guide them and show them what's going on really in the streets out here. And just to think about it, you got 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, like he said, even the 17-year-olds are doing drugs. And you won't, and the parents are not taking time with them to let them even talk to them about what's really, truly going on with them far as the drugs are concerned. You know, every street corner is just sad about how they're doing our kids. Your kids, my kids, black kids, white kids, Spanish kids, whatever. It's just sad.
Are you the two young girls that were that was caught buying drugs from that guy?
Yes.
Y'all were buying drugs?
Yes.
When did you start using drugs and what made you want to buy drugs?
What made me want to start buying drugs? I thought it was healthy for me to do. And because we saw our friends doing it.
You saw your friends using drugs, so y'all started.
Yeah.
So that guy, he told y'all that he sold y'all the dope.
Mm-hmm.
You sold to two little young girls?
Yes.
And what happened? Did they buy the drugs?
Yes.
So what happened when you got home?
My mom had found the drugs in my pocket because it had fell out, right?
Your mom found the drugs and fell out your pocket?
Yes.
Okay.
And then she tried to send me to rehab.
She tried to send you to rehab?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Well, are y'all going to do that anymore?
No.
You finished with the drugs, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Y'all be good. Say, what'd you say to drugs?
Don't do drugs.
Don't do drugs. That's bad. Okay, thank you.
Amen.
I know that I will.
Kids were younger, they always had a buddy system. They walked to school with friends, they came home with friends. But the kids nowadays, they don't do that. And then when they are in groups, a lot of times it's gangs. Also, when strangers walk up and, you know, saying different things like offer them money to do this or do that, you know, they jump in the car and follow them, and then we don't see them anymore. Someone come up, offer them money, or, you know, say they looking for their dog, or, you know, I'll give you $10 if you help me find my dog, jump in the car with me. Kids are not really street smart when it comes to that. So that's why a lot of our kids are jumping in the car with strangers, trusting everyone, and that's not good. And parents need to start teaching their kids, you know, a little bit more better about who to trust and who not to trust.
What can you explain what could have happened to you as, you know, young children?
What could have happened? We could have got kidnapped and never been seen then.
We could have got killed and a lot of stuff happened.
We were lost, baby. We didn't know we were at.
We could have got hurt and
she should have got the, well, she didn't get the candy, but if she did, she should have got it because it didn't have anything inside of there.
What else would have happened if you were that close? You know,
he could have smashed us up. And if it happened, he should have never came up to little girls.
You ready? But one of the things that's happening in my life personally is that my own family member got grazed the other day from gun violence. And it's so sad, you know, because it just don't affect him, but a person who get it, it affects my whole family. It affects his brothers. It affects his mother, his grandmother, his uncles. See, it's not just y'all that it affects. It affects everybody. It's a ripple effect. A ripple effect. And it's sad. Because I love this young man so much. And if something had happened to him, thank God he only got grazed. But suppose if it was worse. Suppose if it was worse. I'd be mourning right now. Like so many other parents mourn today. See, y'all don't realize it just don't hurt y'all. It hurt everybody. It hurt our community. It hurts you after you realize when you wake up what you did. And who you did it to. You didn't just do it to the person in that family, you did it to your own family. They missed out on your love. They missed out on your respect. They missed out on you. They missed out on you. Because of you doing silly things. It's hurting.
We've got some difficult days ahead. But it really doesn't matter with me now. Because I've been to the mountaintop. To live a long life, longevity has its place.
And start keeping an eye on the children as to what they're doing. It's going to continue.
But I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And he's allowed me to go up to the mountain. And I've seen the promised land. I may not get there with you, but I want you to know tonight that we as a people will get to the promised land. So I'm happy tonight. I'm not worried about anything. I'm not fearing any man. My seen the glory.
what's going on with the kids, what they're doing out there in those streets. No guardians. They have no guardians. So that even these kids are getting the guns from the parents. The parents are laying around. Children are shooting children because it's a game to them, you know. Because they see it on TV, a lot of violence on TV, so when they do see a gun, they pick it up and play with it, which is not good because they wind up killing their sisters or brothers or cousins. And then the parents are upset about it, but they should have put it up, lock it up. Get some type of gun closet with a lock on it. That way the kids can't get a hold of it. But until families wake up and start keeping an eye on their children as to what they're doing, it's going to continue.